Get ready to match the stars from Mork and Mindy, Conrad Janet, Brett Summers, Paul Williams, from Harper Valley PTA, Edie McClurg, McLean Stevenson, and Debralee Scott, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Reverend.
Virginia, Cynthia. Hello, 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 hello.
Hello, hello, hello.
I almost tripped over these on the way out. Someone accidentally left a...
Oh, those are my nails.
These are what they
those
call
are my nails.
Stage nails. They have two heads because in the theater...
Two heads of what?
They never drive a nail all the way in. They just drive it to that point, and then when they're ripping the set apart, it's easy to take the nails out,
right.
You see.
Right, yeah. Well, yes. You learn something every day, don't you, Gene?
That's
yeah.
Right. Would you like these as a gift, a token of my esteem
sure,
for you?
Sure, I'll glue them to my bed. Why not?
All right. Okay.
She made me laugh.
Let's say hello to Virginia Schutz and Cynthia Walter. You remember Virginia? She's from Wisconsin, cold
right.
country.
Cold.
And she has many hobbies. And she has a very full, rich life, as Virginia has. And Cynthia here picked me up off the floor yesterday. She's a body, what do you call yourself, a bodybuilder?
Oh, call me whatever you want.
Well, I don't know.
Just call me.
Cynthia, which one? Which one is your husband out there?
Oh,
where is your,
he's down there in a yellow shirt with a blue collar.
He's a real yeah. thin guy.
Wade.
What's his name?
Mark.
Wade.
Mark
Wade.
Walter.
Mark Walter.
Mark, her muscles are bigger than yours. Look at that. What?
No, they got the wrong guy.
They got the wrong guy?
Yeah, the one
wave they... again, Mark. Right now, Mark, show us your muscles. Hers are bigger than yours.
Yeah.
Wow.
The first guy that they
looked
at, she'd kill, you know?
Listen, right. I like the other Mark, the one up in the back. He's
where was,
cuter
who was
than the
mistaken
one
Mark,
in the
raise your hand.
Here.
I didn't see him.
Oh. Where's my...
The
kid
he's up there? He's 12 years old.
Well, quit waving then, kid.
She'd break him in two. What are you talking about?
Right. What do you mean, no way? She's not a bad-looking broad.
All right.
Shay.
The ERA, the NOW organization, doesn't approve of that kind of talk. Cynthia, are you ready?
Yes, sir.
This is your first round question. Ed said, Paul Newman isn't so hot.
That's not what Joanne
said. Ed's stupid, isn't he?
Paul Newman isn't so hot.
Isn't.
How hot isn't he?
Isn't he?
Well, here's the way. Take away his good looks, his personality, his great body, and what have you got? You got blank. That's what you got.
His what? Take away his... You gotta run that by again.
Take away his good looks, his body, his personality, and what have you got? Thank you. Ready for Cynthia? It's Paul Newman isn't so hot. Take away his good looks.
The little fella's not quite finished.
He's doing artwork, isn't he?
On the upper deck. We're not quite ready on the upper deck.
No, he hasn't finished his little... There
he goes. There you go. The answer is finished.
Paul Newman isn't so hot. Take away his good looks, his personality, his great body, and what have you got? You've got blank.
That's about what I've got.
Whoa!
You've got a race car.
A race car?
Yeah.
Well, we were thinking of a person that you might name who wouldn't have a great body or a wonderful personality.
Oh, well, I thought of somebody else who was handsome.
Who's
Howard
that?
Cosell.
Howard Cosell, right. That's one possibility.
You take it all away, and what have you got left?
What have you got?
Our good friend, our buddy, our fabulous friend, Howie Cosell.
All right, two of those.
You've got a competitive spirit and a Datsun. You've got a Nomex suit and a helmet and blue eyes. I thought you'd go for that, because he hates it when you talk about his blue eyes, and now he's going to hate me really bad.
I don't know what your answer is.
Blue eyes.
Blue eyes. Blue eyes. Oh, what have you got? Blue eyes. That's
should
all you got left.
Datsun a couple times,
else.
Because
okay.
He'll like that.
Take all that stuff away from Paul Newman, his body, his good looks, personality, and what have you got? You've got...
Well, I guess you'd have someone kind of insecure and kind of small and not really, oh, I guess maybe, well, could be, but perhaps, but it might be Woody Allen.
Woody Allen.
Yeah.
Right. McLean.
Hi, I'm McLean Stevenson. I'm from Bloomington, Illinois. I enjoy curling, off-track racing, and petty point. For my answer, I chose to say me.
Oh. don't think so. Oh. Give him a little kiss.
Are you going to kiss him on the lips again?
Oh, wait.
No. No, 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 McLean. It's McLean.
Oh, shut up. The key word to that, because I am a game player, folks, is Ed. Ed said.
Ed said. Well, so, what does that mean?
I have no idea.
He was taking on so much Ed, you see.
That's right.
Can I say my answer? Putting himself yeah.
Would you like to say your answer?
I would. I mean, it's not so wonderful,
yeah.
But I would like to get it.
All right, I'll tell you what. I'll make
McClane,
a deal.
You mean.
I'll have some of your ginger ale.
Okay.
You say your answer.
Well, you got to read it.
Ed said, Paul Newman said. Paul
put
Newman
out your cigarettes with his breath now.
Paul Newman isn't so hot. Take away his good looks, his personality, his great body, and what have you got? You've got
Joanne Woodward alone.
Joanne Woodward alone.
How about Don Knotts?
All right. Let's go to round two here. And Virginia, you're ahead 1-0. That means you have to go first.
I'll take B again.
B again it is. One person does not play. That's Conrad. Are the rest of you ready for this?
Yes.
The Irishman said.
I'll never eat another mushroom. I just found out that leprechauns blank in the woods.
Aha. Noel Coward.
You know, you have to think of all these stupid words.
Pass me a potato, would you? Just fit in the mood for a little potato.
Well, I guess we're all ready for you, Albert. The Irishman said, I'll never eat another mushroom. I just found out that leprechauns blank in the woods.
I will have to say tinkle.
Yeah! All right.
Tinkle, I'm shocked.
Nay, appalled.
Yes, Miss
Beth. Is that me?
Yep.
I'm shocked, nay, appalled. I don't know what a grown woman is doing saying things like this. Make it a doo-doo.
Make it a doo-doo. It's a baby talk show. That's
yeah,
what we got.
Yeah, that's what I
got. Words.
Why did I read the guy?
I said, Irish people are always going, toy, 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 toy. So they say they make toy, toy, toy. That's the same
they
as
make toy, 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 toy. All right.
This is a child. I mean,
I'll never eat another mushroom. We just found out the leprechaun's blank in the woods.
Well, you know I'm Irish.
Are you Irish?
Yes, she's wearing the green, is she?
McClurg, of course you're
that's
Irish.
Fine.
Yes.
And I know that what leprechauns do in the woods.
Oh, really? What do they do?
They go...
Okay. All right, we got the idea. Thanks a lot. All right. Okay. Little rascals.
I cannot believe that 5, possibly 6, and with Virginia 7 grown folk are using words like tinka, caca, toy toy.
Doo-doo.
Doo-doo. Yeah. I mean, come on. We know what it is. It's poop.
You know, really what it is, it's... No.
No.
I'm Irish, too. My great-great-grandmother's name is Bridget O'Shaughnessy.
Bridget O'Shaughnessy.
Because I am going to be the...
It doesn't mean she can...
Are you ready for this? Piddle.
Piddle.
That's a
man.
That's a man. Yay. Oh, get her out of here.
All right. There we are in the middle of round two. 3-0 your score. You got some catching up to do right after this for you. Here we go.
And it was passé.
Oh,
right. Ira told me before the show that was passé. We
right.
never do that anymore.
Right, never. Now, Cynthia, you need 3 to tie and 4 to win in this game. Are you
I'm
ready?
I'm trying to contain
pay
myself.
Pay attention.
Oh,
getting
gosh.
Over the left
all right.
On in the
Mel said.
Mel
said.
When I was a kid, we were so poor, if we smelled meat cooking, we knew the blank was on fire.
Oh,
Come on, girl.
Come on, Jane.
Okay.
Now, while the doctor tucks him back in,
expect
and so
is
Virginia.
Do you? Here it is. Mel said, "When I was a kid, we were so poor. If we smelled meat cooking, we knew the blank was on fire."
Cat.
Cat is one possibility. It's a very good one.
That's not the right answer. Here's the right answer.
There's the right answer. Cat. 3-1 the score. Rhett?
Well, they're all crawling around on their 4 feet with the rest four-legged, with the rest of the drunks, but I said dog.
All right.
Get on with it. I said the butcher shop, and I'm sorry. I was wrong.
The butcher shop was on fire. If we smelled meat butcher cooking, shop. We knew the blank was on fire. What'd you say, Edie?
I said the dog.
The dog. Now you got to match McLean and Debralee to stay in the game and achieve a tie.
But they'd be too poor to have
a
dog.
Can I go first? So he's like the awful person.
You want to go first?
Yeah.
All right, go ahead.
See, I said cat.
All right, so it's 3-2. That's all up to you, McLean.
All on your shoulders.
Hey, I don't give a caca, okay? You think I give a doo-doo? Piddle on you, I don't... Come on, all right, boys and girls. Uncle Max said, doggy or bow wow.
Doggy or bow wow. That means Virginia wins the game. There. Now, we'll wheel you off, but we'll wheel you back later for game number two,
okay.
So don't go too far away. And wear the red dress, too. All right. Good luck to you, my dear. You can win a bundle of money here. We polled the studio audience, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Testing blank.
Uh-huh.
Now, 3 of the 6 stars will assist you. You call on them one at a time.
Yeah, well, Conrad is on my wavelength.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah. Testing, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah. Testing.
Brett.
Testing. What you got on? Oh, that's nice. Oh, that's nice. Testing operation.
Oh, come on. Brett,
I'm going to take care.
Testing ground.
Testing ground. All right. We have testing operation, testing 1, 2, 3, 4, and testing operation, and ground, and 1, 2, 3, 4, and ground,
right,
and operation.
I think he's wondering.
Where shall we make the incision? Oh, all right.
Testing. You want to know my decision?
Yeah,
we'd like to.
1, 2, 3.
Right, four. You're right,
testing, 1, 2, 3, 4. All right. Let's find out if it's up there,
it's
Virginia, and if so, where? May we see the bottom one, please? Testing ground is there. All right, McLean gave you that one. The next one says, testing, testing. Testing, testing.
Testing.
Right. Thank you. The bottom, the top one says, 1, 2, 3. There we go. All right. Now, Virginia, you've got $500. It means at least you'll be playing for us 10 times that amount, or $5,000. But we want you to step up here and spin the wheel and see if you can double it up and play for $10,000. Good luck to you. Have a go at it. Isn't that interesting? He gave you the big one there, the $500 one, and now you're going to play for $5,000 with Conrad. Good luck to you. Remember, your job is to match him. This is it. Blank clams. C-L-A-M-S. Blank clams. What do you say to that? To match him, how would you fill in that blank?
Sea clams.
Sea clams. You really are a Midwesterner, huh? Have you ever seen the ocean?
Yes, out here.
Oh, out here, that's right. You've seen the Pacific Ocean. Well, living in the East.
I said steam clams.
Steam clams. Steam clams. Well, there are all kinds of clams. a number of good possibilities.
Steve, bacon, fried, what
That's
else?
Right. You don't like clams? Well, I love them, except they're a little high in cholesterol. All crustaceans are, but they are delicious. Virginia, you got $500. You're going to have another shot at it with game number two later, but first this for you, friends.
Where is he?
Hello.
Well, now she's got $500. This is the second and final game, ladies. Let's see how it goes. You ready, Cynthia?
Sure.
What would you like?
B, please.
All right. Pete said, I just saw a revised version of Tarzan. It was really revised. In this version, Tarzan doesn't live in a tree. He lives in a blank.
How about the old Bo Derek out there taking it all off, huh?
She did in this. I haven't seen it. Have you?
I haven't seen it either. I think it's something that... I thought it was interesting. We were marching for the ERA last Saturday, and there was Bo Derek. Doing a lot of that.
People don't, a lot of people don't realize for many, many years he held five Olympic records which weren't broken until 40 or 50 years.
Johnny Weissman.
What?
One of the great swimmers. He revolutionized swimming, the industry. I guess that means they're finished. Right. He said, I just saw a revised version of Tarzan. It was really revised. In this version, Tarzan doesn't live in a tree. He lives in a blank.
A penthouse apartment.
A penthouse apartment. All right. Well, I guess you could do a little swinging up there, couldn't you?
Oh, are you cute?
Okay, Conrad, you're
well,
up.
Well, I think I'm close. I said a condo.
A condo.
Yeah.
Well, a condo is not necessarily in the penthouse, you see. It could be on a third floor, rear.
Okay.
What do you say?
Oh, not the prices they're charging today. You've got to insist upon living at the top. I also said condominium. I regret to say I wish I had...
They're building a whole bunch of them out here now. What do you say, Paul?
I said, class, I guess, shows. I was going to say in a trailer park, but I said condominium. It's really pretty sad.
Trailer
There's nothing
park?
Funny about it. Yeah. Nothing's funny anymore since I quit drinking nothing.
It's all right. I'll get him at dinner.
Boom. We love you.
God bless you.
Right. You're all right, Edie. Revised version of Tarzan, and this one, Tarzan doesn't live in a tree. He lives in a...
Hi. My name is Bo Derek. Whenever I'm running naked through the forest with primates, I want to make sure I have a nice warm condo to go home to.
Okay, send it over to McLean.
McLean. Thank you, Edie, and here's an update on that next answer. I said a camper.
A camper. This Tarzan living in a tree lives in a camper. What do you say?
A mobile home.
A mobile home. Another word for camper. Well,
not another word.
All right. That's yours. Yours will be long in a moment. Now this for you. Ira Scutch does not eat fish. It makes him break out in hives. He doesn't eat clams or fish or anything. He eats clams but no fish.
Kill for some Maine fried clams and crumbs for all you people who don't like clams. Get in your cars, drive to Maine, go to Kennebunkport and ask for clams fried in crumbs. That's my message for the day.
Nobody makes them like Earl Mills, my friend.
Where's he?
He owns the Flume restaurant at he's got the best in the
world.
Where
is this restaurant?
It's in Mashpee. You know where Mashpee is? It's a great place.
There he is.
Listen, don't forget to watch Conrad on Mork and Mindy. And watch Brett at JCPenney.
No, I'm directing a play.
Oh, yeah, what are you directing?
That's right, I'm directing a play. I'm directing Marcia Wallace in a play called An Almost Perfect Person. We open in November 5th.
Yes. And what are you doing?
I'm saying it's time to say goodbye.
Oh, anybody else? That's it, huh? Okay, say goodbye, Gene. Join us next time for the match game. Goodbye.
Today's contestants will also receive Hush Puppies gloves for work and casual wear. Active men and women choose Hush Puppies, their hands' best friend. And Niagara is America's number one spray starch, helps prevent the deep penetration of soil and stain. A new Purina Moistened Chunky tastes better and now costs less than the leading competitor. Moistened Chunky dog food, better taste for your dog, lower price. And when you've got anything that sticks or squeaks, reach for WD-40. Makes things work smoother, last longer. Do it yourself with WD-40. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. The program was edited for broadcast. Thank you.